Hello, my name is Erin. This tutorial shows how to create WordArt in Microsoft Word. WordArt is a special form of text that can be modified like an object. First, we'll look at how to insert WordArt. Then, we'll look at how to customize it and resize and position it within the document. I'll be using Word for Microsoft 365. These steps also apply to Word for Mac and the single purchase versions of the software back to Word 2016. To begin, place your cursor in the text where you want to insert the word art. This can be an approximate placement because it can be moved later. Next, select the Insert tab, followed by the Word Art button. From there, select one of the default designs from the drop-down menu. Don't worry if none of the defaults are perfect, because we'll be looking at how to modify these designs in the next section. After making your choice, a text box will appear with the filler text, Your Text Here. It will already be selected, so you can immediately type your own text to replace the filler text. There are many ways to customize WordArt. For the sake of brevity, this section is limited to the options I believe will be the most helpful for most users. To change the font, size, and emphasis, select the text, and then select the Home tab. From there, you can choose a new option from the Font menu and Font Size menu. You can also select the bold, italic, or underline button for emphasis if desired. Now we're going to change the colors and add advanced effects. To begin, select the Shape Format tab. You may notice that this tab only appears when WordArt or a shape is selected. Next, select the Text Fill menu arrow and choose a new color or gradient from the drop-down menu. You can also select the Text Outline menu arrow, and then select an outline color, weight, or dashed line from the drop-down menu. It's important to note that you have to reselect each of these menu arrows to make multiple choices from the drop-down menus. Next, select the Text Effects menu arrow. From here, you can choose a shadow, reflection, glow, bevel, 3D rotation, or transform effect. Lastly, you can select the text direction button and then choose horizontal, rotate all text 90 degrees, or rotate all text 270 degrees if necessary. To resize your WordArt, select it, and then use the text box resizing handles to drag it to a new size. Note that you can press and hold the Shift key while dragging a corner handle to maintain the current aspect ratio. The top handle lets you rotate the WordArt to the left or right. To change the position of the WordArt in relation to the surrounding text, PC users can select the Layout Options button and then select an option from the Layout menu. Mac users can access the same menu by selecting the Arrange button, followed by Wrap Text. If you select an option other than inline with text, you can select and grab the image and then move it almost anywhere in the document. Today I'm going to choose square. After creating your WordArt, you may want to save it as an image for use outside of Microsoft Word. To do so, right-click it on a PC or control-click it on a Mac, and then select Save as Picture from the shortcut menu. You can then name and save it as you would a regular image. And as always, remember to save your file to save your changes. All the steps we just performed are listed with images on my website at erinwrightwriting.com, which is linked in the description box below, along with my playlists, How to Use Microsoft Word, and How to Use Word for Mac. Feel free to leave me a comment if there's a specific topic that you'd like me to talk about in the future. And please subscribe to my channel so you don't miss upcoming tutorials. And give this video a thumbs up if you found it helpful. Thank you so much for watching.